To answer the question, can vertical farms be competitive with field farming? That's too broad of a question. Of course not. I mean, on some crops, there's no way you will ever be cost competitive, or not likely in the next 100 years. But on some crops, highly perishable crops, high-value crops, crops that are in demand in niche markets in areas where people want this, but and the big companies can't afford to distribute to or market to, of course, we can be very competitive. And a lot of the time that means delivering a better product. You know, if it involves delivering a better product to the market, then we can charge higher prices, we can improve our margins. And even if there are cost differences in production, the value of the product that you turn out impacts your model significantly. So, you know, just kind of adding to that too, you know, a lot of it is having the wisdom on the front end to identify which crops are worth growing, which crops are worth marketing, and which crops are not, and picking some winners right off the bat. Field production is a massive industry. People don't understand how huge field production is of lettuce, of traditional, these horticultural crops that we're growing indoors, and especially the ones that we're focusing on, you know, herbs, greens, these types of crops. Are we even on the radar? No. we're so minuscule, we're not on the radar. And are we really competitors? I would like to think that most of my customers, most of our upstart farmers, most of the folks in our network have differentiated themselves to the extent that no. I mean, when I take the Tower of Life produce into the store, it is a different product. Again, we focus on selling experience to people, not selling them a product. I'm not interested in selling commodities, I'm interested in selling experiences. And when someone buys our product, they have an opportunity to experience something that they don't typically get to experience. So, in that regard, no, I don't consider the products that we produce and the products that most of our consumers produce, or our customers, as really being competitors to field production. And I think, you know, honestly, we will displace field production over time. We'll take bigger bites, bigger bites, bigger bites. And they'll find themselves at greater disadvantage as time goes on. Will we ever eliminate field production? No way. Especially for some crops. We won't even begin to touch that.